All right, and we're off.
That we
And
are. There we
same
go.
team. Looks like five heavies and a bolter. TR team looks like one, two, three heavies. And they forgot the other three. I see
There's a
one, by the
light.
way.
They have a light assault. No, they've got four heavies, a light assault, and I do believe they still have a bolter on the TR. Let's take a look at the end.
Yeah, TR has one light assault, which I can find, but I cannot find an NC light assault.
I think NC might have gone all heavies in a bolter.
Yeah, looks like it. Which is interesting because if the bolter on the side where the light assault is not is quite good, then it can deny the light assault a lot of flanks, which is important. Because of the high pings, your DPS on people standing still is really important.
So the TI got the point initially, however the NC just seemed to wipe the guys from the building and actually push onto the point. So small cap advantage at the moment for the TI, but that should go relatively soon as long as the NC are quick about it.
One TR shot A and C off point, which was hiding in a corner.
Yep.
With a bright yellow camo, which is bold because, well, it's a scrim, not live play, but if you want to have a bright yellow camo, that is of course allowed.
Yep. So it
TR.
looks like the TR have been the more aggressive on the point. The NC are just kind of sat in the building. Of course, with these kind of numbers, every kill counts. So you've got to be careful not to lose people, not to frag at bad time.
I heard a GD7F.
Yes, the
So it
GG.
could be that the NC has a light assault now. Yes, they do.
Yes. There's also some NC heavy assaults flanking. Let's see what's gonna see what happens with this flank. Don't know if the TR know about it. They didn't get spotted.
Yeah, it's going a long round.
Oh, it looks pretty good actually. They caused a lot of damage. They took out two people and they opened up some room from the point. But it looks like they've been cleared up. Aggression maybe not paying off. The light assault's gonna get a frag. He's gonna run with his GG7F. And he's getting out of there. So the point's actually gonna stay neutral for a bit. The NC are gonna cap it. Fairly well played. Nice flank from the heavy assaults. Really opened up the gaps. Really
Yes,
made
they did.
sure that
It
they could
was a
take the
long
point.
flank, but worth it.
Yeah, it was exactly. The timing worked really well. They pushed onto the point just as that flank started to do its damage. So let's look inside the building. How have the TR recovered? They might be a bit more aware now though, because might start having people watching the flanks to make sure that doesn't happen again. As I say that, another NC heavy assault starts to flank. Yeah, this is a good play.
Yeah, and there's actually two of them. There's one behind that again. But the first one got found out and killed the TR heavy.
So
And
as
the
you can see
second
from
one
the
is still
point,
behind him.
it looks like BHOT is actually leading the lead, but it is narrow. It looks like that, and they have a small like initial lead, but not by much. If they can, whoever caps the base will get a nice healthy lead, because right now these teams are very, very close.
Yep, it does look like that.
Gonna follow the NC bolt around, see what he does.
Yeah, your score in the top left corner is, as far as I know, correct.
Yes.
Combined to the yell of Pronem, the actual referee on which the counting counts.
Yeah.
Oh, light assault on points, got kicked off by NC Heavy. NC Heavy gets. Ooh! Gets helped by a teammate of another NC Heavy, and the TR Heavy dies.
Okay, NC Heavy doing a long flank again. In fact, if the TR Heavy had just turned around there and he'd have caught him, so I don't think they know this. They might be expecting it, but they don't know he's coming. The point looks like it's actually the TR are going to get onto it now, or at least they've got people who should be getting onto the point. And his wipe. There we go, that NC Heavy's flank paying off. I think he was in the second floor. Was it? Nah, yeah, he was. So the NC is going to wrap around, realize there's no one there, and he's going to look back, and there he is. Nah, I didn't take that. So, again, so BHOT, I think 2 points, that's just one kill in the lead.
Correct. 2 points with one kill.
Thank you, my maths. So it really looks like that base cap, whoever gets it, it's going to make a huge difference. But looking at these teams, no one might not get a cap. It's only 15 minutes, it's not a long time when you're playing.
It does look like the cap is just as equal as the score at the moment. It's
Yeah.
just 50-50.
Yeah,
And
50-50 with a
it can
slight
go
lead.
either way.
Yeah.
Especially with the NC heavies flanking the same flank all the time. But until that is got found out, let's see what happens.
I'm not seeing a TI Bolter. Oh, there we go. I turn around and he's there. Okay.
Yeah, TI Bolter is, I would assume, Sika.
Ah, yes, absolutely. Who else would it be?
And does he see the light assault? He does not see the light assault.
And light assault takes him out. He just escapes after chugging some medkit.
Did he actually knife him? Because not that that's extra bonus point, but that's fun points.
And after that little skirmish there, the jokes have taken a huge lead of 12 points at the moment. 12 points, that's a big lead.
That is a big lead.
You know, considering they were like 2 points behind and now they're 12 points ahead, that makes a big difference. Again, though, that's just how quickly momentum and tide of battle can change in these fights.
TR Light Assault is waiting for the TR Heavies to come in to help him out, because it's a bad idea to go alone. I do realize that the new Zelda game is out about 2 weeks, but here in Planetside, it's always dangerous to go alone, too.
Hey, wake up.
I'm getting poked.
It looks like the NC team got wiped. No, the NC team holding on to whatever they got and kicked some TR heavies out.
Indeed. So the score, it's 10 points ahead now for Joke still. The cap point, no one's really bothering with that. Everyone's trying to go for like, trying to get frag needlessly. There we go. Two heavies going to move on for the TR onto the point. Try and get some time back just to make sure the NC don't cap it. Because even if you're not going to go for the point cap yourself, you at least want to deny the enemy's ability, because it is a nice bonus score you get.
Yes, it looks like the TR is going, heavy is going around by balcony, and the NCs are all on the other side of the double building.
So I've got two NC heavy assault and a light assault now flanking. Again, it's the same flank that they're using onto the double stack. I don't see the TR being able to shut it down yet. Jokes are really using this really well. You know, every time there's someone there, they think, if the TR sent one guy to look at it, they'll just send two guys to push. Just to make it a 2v1 to make sure they're not losing people.
Yeah, but that's also the problem. I mean, if you know there's somebody coming in, it doesn't matter if it's one or two, you get an advantage position and a team player with you.
True. So points neutralized, like... points going back to the NC.
I'm being poked too.
I'm actually just looking for people.
Did you link the thingy?
Yeah, I'll do it at halftime if that's alright.
Alright. To people poking us, yes, you'll get the script at halftime.
Yeah, sorry about
that. The point is flipping from NC to TR.
I'd say what happened in this.
NC heavy on point.
Yeah, see what's happened so far, but the TR have been more aggressive, and actually at the moment they're starting to pay the price for it. Hence, the Jokes have actually got a lead. Not a huge lead, but it is a lead in itself. That lead is narrowing, however. It's now only a 7-point lead instead of a 10-point.
It's interesting that usually it's the other way around, but this time the team who has the point also gets the most points.
So here we go. I presume it's Sika with the bolt there. He's actually trying to shut down that flank and he's doing a good job of it. Just making sure they're not exposed on that angle. Really nice. Light Assault actually as well. He's just like peeking around, just looking for anyone to he can take out unaware. Flashbangs. Gotta love him. Mano is with you. Do not falter. Oh, a bit of Light Assault action.
Oh, TR Light Assault wins.
Yeah, he does. Still a 7-point lead for Jokes, though.
TR Light Assault is Boon, as far as we know. Which, he usually plays heavy, he has been training for this type of thing.
Yeah, he's been...
He's doing rather well.
He's been playing a lot of Light Assault, hasn't he? Okay, so currently 9 points ahead for Jokes. I just noticed that Pronoun is actually 2 points behind me, so maybe the scoring is a bit off. It shouldn't be, but...
That could be because he's actually typing it in Yale chat, so it could be delayed a bit.
Yes, that's true. So jokes are really going ahead right now with the lead.
Well, 9 points. It is uneven, so somebody or team killed or suicided. Looks like Joke is going over into Biachoti's double building.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of presence. They're being really aggressive. They've probably fell out throughout this entire match, so it's already been 10 minutes. We've got less than 5 minutes left now. So I think now Jokes are starting to take more gambles. They're starting to take them risks because they know now the type of enemy they're facing. They know how they're going to hit. Starting to get a bit more cocky. Might play against them, but for the most part so far, they do have a little bit of a lead to Ben. But
did you see those that flanked by the two TR heavies on the side?
Which side? Western?
On the BHOT side. They used the side of the double building to get on top of the double building. Which is a nice flank to know and also to do.
Yeah,
because being a light assault is seriously overrated.
Yeah, wall jumps are good. So I've got the NC. There's NC starting to stack up again in their building. I just don't think at this moment in time they want to try and keep this lead. They have a lead, let's just keep it. You know, deny BHOT from taking the point. Again, we're at 11 point lead now for Joke. So, from what was a very even game at the start, actually a lead starting to open up. And there's actually plenty of time for that lead to go back and forth, so you want to try and keep it.
Yeah. Joke is 11 points ahead. TR is trying to group up to flank, but got found out by Lysolt and the Heavy. Now the Heavy is flanking. Here on the side, NC Heavy kills TR Heavy. And flanking NC Heavy around the usual bend. And gets killed by the TR Heavy behind. Which will now run into the building before grouping up and see what they can do again. Ooh,
this
point.
This is definitely becoming a game of retrade, like people trying to find, you know, 2-on-1 fight, trying to trade at least, like that's what it's starting to be, you know. And now because of that, BHOT are like getting closer to a lead now. It's only a 3-point deficit now for them. Jokes have actually lost the lead because they started getting really aggressive. That being said, now there's only a 1-point lead for Jokes from 11 points. They've just lost 10 in the space of 30 seconds.
That is a shame.
Yeah, well, that's what happens.
Yeah, TR really gripped on point, getting into defensive positions. Ooh, two TR heavies going to flank around to the double building of Joke. Let's see what happens inside.
Now it looks like BHOT are the ones with the lead. There's only 1 second left on the point, so if they can cap that point, that'll be huge.
Yes, it will be 24 points. Yes, two TR heavies.
There's a NC heavy on the point, but they capped it. So all of a sudden, that lead. It's back.
That is well played. And also, look at what I said before. Now BHOT is, although what 2 points in the lead, they catched up to Joke and captured a point with.
So it seems that capture wasn't added on to the score.
That is correct. That will be manually calculated.
Okay, but that's
because
24
the
points.
API doesn't work that way.
So at the moment, we've got 1 minute 44 left. And it looks like BHOT are well in the lead. If you add on their 24 point capture, well in the lead.
Did the TR get wiped? Yes.
Yeah, I think the TR got wiped.
Heavy. It looks like it got wiped. Yes, completely wiped now. So, working day for the NC infiltrator, Werner Bolter, because he can see everybody coming in.
So we got 112 to 96 at the moment. That's the score, 112 to 96. My maths, yes. So actually, although it might look like BR or behind, actually they've got a massive lead, 112 to 96, huge. Huge lead. So basically what I'm saying is Jokes have to go overboard with their fragging right now, not lose anyone, take some really good trades. But it just looks like BHOT have gone for damage control. They're just going to make sure that Jokes can't get enough points on them to really catch up. So at the end of the day, although I'd actually say the better fragging was done by Jokes, the actual point capture and overall teamwork seemed to play better in the hands of BHOT, capping that point.
6 at 102 points is 6%. That's 3 kills. I mean, it's not that much better, but it is better.
Mm-hmm. And there's such a high level of infantry player, just a couple of percent in them, you know, key areas can make a huge difference between winning and losing.
Yeah, one good flank could mean a wipe.
Exactly, we've seen it several times now. And talk about flanking. Some NC Heavy is going for a last ditch flank, but it don't matter. 3, 2, 1.
5, 4,
yeah, well.
3, 2, 1. End of round.
End of round, okay. That's it. OBS.
It's not on my screen, it's not end of round yet.
It's end of round, fam.
The last thing I saw was 30 seconds left.
That might be because the stream's like 30 seconds behind me.
Yes, possibly.
Yes.
Ah, well. That works. Alright. Now for some intermittent classical music while we talk through it. How do you get out of the observer cam, by the way?
E. So what is it people Twitter?
Oh yeah, of course, my whisper thingy is off. I thought it was still on. That's why I didn't know it was finished.
How do I link you the scarf, huh?
Just... you can link the Fizu one.
The Fizu one, what?
Oh, you don't know about the Fizu one.
I don't.
Give me a moment, I'll help you.
Thank you. I'm getting tech support on stream, fam.
But since you do not have ran the Fizu one, maybe Pronem can link it. I'll talk to him.
Yeah, in fact, go by the ref stats.
User left your channel.
I trust the ref of a mate. Said this was a really bang this all together, make sure it worked. Kind of ordeal. Oh, I can tell my voice is pretty shot as well, so I'm not in the best of minds right now.
User joined your channel.
All right, in this Twitch chat, Pronem just linked to the actual scores by referee, although Fizu is 10 seconds behind, so it could not be correct, but most of the time it is. Again, link in chat by Pronem for the actual scores. Not the referee scores, but the actual scores. This was a good half.
Yeah. I think I observed it alright. Probably not, but I give it a shot. So, how long will halftime be? 3.5 minutes. Ah, well.
NC is ready already. They're ready to go. The point is flipped and done.
They want to get some revenge.
Probably. I mean, it's not that far off, so anything could happen.
Indeed.
But most of the time, there are more points per round, so more aggressiveness. More deaths and kills. So this is actually quite non-aggressive, relaxed, well, I wouldn't say relaxed, play by both teams. I have refereed myself and I've seen scores in two rounds go over 300. So, yeah, lots of passive, lots of good flanks by most of the time the heavies, of course. Most of the time the light assault is continuously flanking when possible. For if you are playing a light assault in the scrim, especially on this base, it's really important to know where the enemy bolter is, because if the bolter knows your place, he will head or body shot you, and in both times you're equally dead. I mean, if you get a body shot, you're most likely will be spotted, so a heavy only needs to put 3 bullets into you and you're dead. Especially with the ping to Jaeger from Europe. Yeah, it's just a dense sentence. If you do know where the enemy bolter is, you know how to flank. Let me check the stats linked by Fizu.
10, 9, 8.
About who's positive
7,
and negative.
6, 5, 4.
Johannes on a net score of
0. Boom, one.
Minus four. Neto. Usually he's the carry of the team. What I have seen the last couple of times. But maybe this time because it has a enemy bolter. And an enemy lies that has some issues. Also, it has started again.
Yes, it has. Here we go. It's got on the point now, yeah. So I expect similar setups for both teams. Just talk about the boon on Light Assault. Maybe it's more to do with the base, because I don't know if they played Pearl Canyon yet. Anyway. NC this time being the aggressive ones on point. Maybe a spawn advantage on that side, we'll have to see. But yeah, so the TI did actually flip the point, but only for a matter of seconds. The NC got the really aggressive point hold. Really good flanks as well. Again, the NC playing for the flank game, playing for the frags. Early lead as well. 2 points for the TR to 10 points for the NC. Big lead. Especially this early on in the game. It's quite different to what we've seen in the previous game. Wall jumping.
Like it.
Yeah.
Lots of work at primary.
We'll have to see if both teams like play as passive again or if this time they kick it into overdrive and start playing more aggressive. Some great 2v1.
Assault is still on the TR roof. NC Heavy's in the building.
Oh my god. This time
position of that NC bolter is really bold. It's near the balcony of the northern double building.
So many whiff shots right now. What's happening? It looks like jokes are out for blood. BHOT just kind of getting pushed back. The point, already a minute left. This is explosive compared to the last game. I see points getting flipped, but I don't see anyone. Maybe it's the TR infiltrator.
I don't see anyone either.
The TR are getting on the flanks now. They're putting some conks in, but the NC are, by the looks of the minimap, of three people already stacked in this room. Just waiting for someone to try and flank. Finally, they can take the point, so looks like the NC is going to have some recapping to do. Boom, by the looks of things, this Light Assault is kind of struggling to position himself. Looks a bit uncomfortable.
Oh, keeping moving is a good idea to not get shot instantly like that.
Yeah. It's just what, instead of being like tokenly aggressive and maybe looking for picks, he's actually just like being a bit more defensive, a bit more passive, a bit more reserved. There we go. The NC Heavy's still on point, just cowering away, making sure he's ticking the point up. TI have a good spread around the western side of the base, but they're not really in any buildings. That being said, they finally make a push. Pushing onto point. Come on, lads, make that 2v1. Well done. The NC Bolter's
behind. Nope. That NC Bolter is more downstairs than upstairs, which is weird.
Yeah, maybe it's
your Bolter is upstairs, but that might be the good reason. I mean, if you are a bolter and you get bolted into the head, yeah, there's not much you can do about it apart from cloak. Oh, and see Heavy getting a long flank around.
So it looks like, again, so we saw this huge lead actually by Jokes, and now it's been basically BHOT are now in the lead. Just by 2 points. So they've definitely made a comeback. Maybe it was just a sloppy opening, getting used to playing the different side. But Jokes actually flanks getting shut down. This is getting dangerous again.
Yeah, that NC Heavy who got long got spotted by our bolter. So he cannot run because he will get shot.
I mean, this is the thing, right? They're going for the solo flank. And it can be great if it pays off, but if you get spotted, or if people start to get wise, which is what's happening now, then unfortunately these guys are going to get shut down. And that's what's happening, so the TR are finally wise, because those flanks were pretty devastating. But it looks like now they've got people watching them, heavies, you know, stacked up, conks out. And they're getting shut down. Bob, I will.
See, we're on point, but TR actually recaptured the point again. It looks like the NC did a flank with at least four people, got wiped, killed two TR, and then respawned again. Because the NC are just two in the building, and that's all.
Yeah, if guys in the stream, I'll post my config after it. It's basically, it's full ultra, everything on high or ultra or whatever. I'll post afterwards.
That's not what he normally does. He normally plays on potato.
I use the third potato, just quick. Yeah, that's everything on ultra.
Yeah, his Ini is available on his Twitch, Marty, but this is his stream thingy, not his...
Yeah. Don't worry, I don't normally play on ultra. So anyway, back to the game. NC went hard onto the point. Now they're the ones in control. TI pushed back to the building. Again, the scores are pretty 50-50, a small lead for the TI. As we've seen before, this can go either way very quickly.
Correct.
Yeah, the TR right now.
He has the point again for a long time because TR almost captured it. I think they were 24 seconds off or something.
Yeah, it was close. Yeah, Mouty, that isn't the config I'm running. In fact, I haven't run that config in a while. I'll update it soon.
Two NC heavies going for the flank, the long flank.
Yeah, the long flank, sir. This time no one was watching it. They get a quick 2v1. Nice trade. Scores are even. Like, if I'm BHOT right now, I just want to, like, focus on not losing people, not trading, and just making sure we get a presence again on the point. That seems to be what's happening. Boom, the light assault. Here he goes. He's going to go in. He's running back out. He's scared. The jumping heavy meta. It happened.
Yeah, let me actually watch that on your stream.
Hashtag jump meta. Boom, just cowering in a corner, putting his flashbangs out.
Well, I don't think it's cowering. I mean, you have less health than any heavy, so...
Heavy's taking the high ground now. Your light assault jetpack bullshittery means nothing when a heavy can get on here.
Yep. Yeah, the Tialo assault is still on point.
Yeah, NC have got a real heavy presence now. Point's flipping. Boone's just, you know, touching it just to keep sure it doesn't keep peeking. Just while the TI missed. But the NC now come for the flank. And will the TI be able to stop it? They've got one guy, but it's a two-man flank. It's a two-man flank. He's got to run. I got wrecked. So the point's up for the TI. They're just leaving the flanks behind. NC Bolt on the point as well. Taking him out. What's the score?
TR low assault kills. Two NC heavies in short modus. Notice one off the point and one inside their building.
Yeah. Again, this is one of them situations where both teams are so even, it's going to take one, you know, usually what we saw before, a point cap to kind of separate them. So both teams should be keep up the current play and be peeking for the point a bit more. This is a really passive game. Really passive.
Yeah, no. Well, that's what happens if you do not want to give away any points. I mean, I understand why BHRT is passive, because they're ahead. But that doesn't mean Joke shouldn't be passive.
Exactly.
You can always catch up to it in the end.
It's about trades and making good ones. Look at that ball of saving his hand. Oh my god.
Oh, that wow. Was a nice bolt.
Where is he? Is he inside?
No, he was on top of the roof.
I didn't see him. Oh, they're sick of just, jeez, you know. And by players like that, what you're doing is you're stopping the enemy from getting points and you're getting points, just gaining a bigger lead. I mean, it's 72-66 now, BHRT. Getting that lead they needed. Jokes, on the other hand, that was a really nice play, that flank. A lot of people committed to it. You know, surely you're not going to not gonna get wiped, but unfortunately they did. In for air. Yeah, so you can see the jokes are really trying to flank a lot more than the TR. The TR aren't really flanking at all. They're just kind of playing passive, like you say. They're trying to conserve their own point, making sure that nobody dies in positions where they shouldn't have been. It's very passive and can be quite boring to watch, but it is rewarding if you can make it work, and these guys are pros at making it work.
Bolts NC heavy flank behind the TR double building now. He's inside downstairs on the double. Got found out and yeah. meets, kills two TR heavies, and then dies itself. I mean, that's a plus 2 points for your own team. Of course, you could have wished it was more, but you got outplayed. And he was on his own, so it's understandable.
But at the moment, the NC are just throwing themselves at the point, trying to make sure that the TR don't cap it, but 20 seconds left, 20 seconds on the point, it's going to be close. They know that if they hit the... if the TR can get the point again, it's going to be a huge lead gain. And they can't afford that right now. They need to win this. But BHOT, you know, everlasting aggression from these guys.
Oh, lots of aggressiveness there on point indeed.
Yeah, I'm just trying to keep an eye on point. Again, some small flanks, NC Light Assault, just kind of run around. The point is in the hand of the NC. There's just one guy on it. Oh, he's going to get wrecked. Yes, he is. So the point's going to flip again. Like, every second counts at this stage if you're the NC. You don't want them to come close to capping this point again. But it's going to happen. They're going to come close. See, NC just got to run people onto the point right now. This late in the game, they can't afford this deficit again.
Yes, but the problem with that is that makes you playing aggressive and predictable. That means
exactly.
You will get flanked because you have 1 point, which is the point.
It's a double-edged sword, you know, you stop the cap of the point, but at the same time, you basically trade a load of guys for points. And that being said, the point's going to go through anyway, so again, add 24 to that score. That is a huge lead at the moment for BHOT. You know, we've seen a really passive game. I don't know if the NC can make this up, if jokes are finished right now. You know, they've just got to...
Depends. Yeah, they're 14 below, yes. It's going to be really hard for them, especially in 3 minutes 25 seconds and less. So, yeah. It's a shame, really. I mean, the whole game was just going perfectly fine, equal, until there were caps. But on the other hand, it's really deserved. I mean, if you can capture a base with this type of 66, with this type of skill, you kind of deserve it.
Like, this is a weird game. It's very passive, and it's been small things which have got people to lead. Small things. Again, right now, BHOT just trying to play passive. They're not going for the kills anymore. They're playing more passive than they were before, making sure they're not dying, making sure they're not giving up points and giving up their lead. They have a huge lead. They don't need to worry. They just need to focus on being the defensive team. And once you establish that defensive position, you get things like defender's advantage, which, you know, allow you to kind of stack people in rooms. And the NC are going to have to be more aggressive if they want to get back into this. But again, they're going to open themselves up for flank.
I wouldn't call it a defender's advantage, it's just more of a aggressor's disadvantage.
Ah, okay.
Because being aggressive makes you predictable. Being aggressive makes you vulnerable. Because you're not waiting for that other friendly to go with you with the flank, because you need to kill them in time.
Yeah, with the time at the moment, there's no way they can actually cap the base, so that right now the NC have just got to go for kills. BHOT now, they just need to stack up together, make sure they don't get wiped. You know, Sick has been doing a fantastic job bolting, just denying so many, like, what should have been easy kills for the NC. Who would you say has been the...
heavy on the NC roof.
I'm trying to find people now, I could just see blips on the map. So, NC Light Assault kills the bolter. Rip. NC Light Assault kills Boone. NC Light Assault going huge. He's going huge. Oh, he kind of helps the trade.
It looks like the TR got wiped.
Yeah, it did, actually. I don't think they're in any danger yet in terms of points because of their leads from capping. But it could change. There is still time. Well, I say that. There's 40 seconds left. Not a great deal of time. TR just, you know, stacking up together, trying to get them last couple of kills.
Yeah, the NC need to make up for a lot of kills in this small amount of time. Ah, in the yell, there's 30 seconds left.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to manage it.
If you look at the yell, you can see that the kill points is exactly the same by referee. But because BSOT captured the base twice, one in, once in the first half, one in the second half, they are 48 points.
7, up front. 6, 5, 4.
I mean, just like
three,
the other match with
two,
AMOL
one,
versus Addicted to Medkits.
Yeah.
That was so ridiculously close that the referee did not know it beforehand.
This is. There we go. It's a sign.